Greetings and welcome to the first episode of Hacking for Dummies. In this episode, I'll show you how you can install Kali Linux on your computer as a virtual machine and have a safe place to play around with things. Disclaimer: this video is meant for educational purposes only and I do not promote any illegal activities. A virtual machine is an operating system installed inside your operating system. We use a software which helps us install different operating systems on a single computer. The cool thing about these virtual machines are they are isolated and they work as an independent operating system. There is a special software called hypervisor which helps our computer allocate necessary resources to the virtual machine like CPU, storage, memory. Now that you have basic understanding of what a virtual machine is, let's see why we need it. Since we are going to be learning hacking, which means breaking the system, we need a safe place to practice our activities and keep these activities isolated. For that, we are going to use virtual machines. To have an operating system which is isolated and independent, so even if we break it, which we will, it doesn't matter. All we need to do is reset it or install a new virtual machine and we can continue working. We are going to be testing, installing, doing all kind of hacking in this course, so we need a virtual machine to play around. You can use VMware or VirtualBox to install virtual machine. We will be using VirtualBox because it's completely free and open source. Unlike VMware, VMware is also free but they also have paid options. The reason we are using Kali Linux is because it's beginner friendly, easy to use operating system. It has all the hacking tools we need pre-installed in it. Since the majority of servers are using Linux as their operating system, it is important to learn how Linux works and how you can work with Linux and perform different tasks. One another reason is Kali Linux is very popular, so if you are stuck or facing an issue, you can always Google it. I bet majority of the time you will find the solution. Open your favorite browser and search for VirtualBox. Then click on the first link. Then click on download. Select the operating system you are using. Right now I'm using Windows, so I'll select Windows. Select the one you are using. Now download the VirtualBox extension pack. You can see the all supported platforms. Click on there. Wait till it's downloaded. Now click on the executable file. Click on next, again next, and yes. Yes, and click on install. Click on finish. Then click on the extension pack you downloaded, so we will be able to install it. So the extension pack gives us more functionalities, like we can use a physical USB device in the virtual machine. It's gonna be useful, so install it. Now click on install. And click on agree and it will be installed. Let's download Kali Linux too. So search for Kali Linux on your favorite browser. Click on the first link. It should be kali.org. Then click on download. Then select installer images. Now you will see the installer 64 bits. So click on that download button. Now save it wherever you like. Make sure you remember where you saved it. As you can see, I have installed few virtual machines already on my computer. So to get started, you will have to click on the new. Now give it a name. Select the type to Linux. Now select the version and click on other Linux 64 bits. Now give it a memory. I suggest giving it at least 2 GB, but if you have low memory, like you have 8 gigs or something like that, then give it 1 gig would do fine. But since we will be doing some heavy hacking like Active Directory or something similar in future, so I suggest keeping it to 2 gigs. give it at least 2 cores. Now choose the memory around 30 to 40 gigs. Now click on finish. Now go to settings. Now click on advanced, select both of the options to bidirectional, so that way we can copy paste and drag and drop things. Now click on storage, select the empty disk below controller IDE. Now click on the disk icon. Now click on choose a disk file. Locate the Kali file we downloaded earlier. Now go to networks and select NAT network. So the reason we are selecting NAT network is in future when we are going to install different vulnerable machines to hack, we want them to be in a separate network, in a network in which we can communicate with it. So that's why we are using NAT network. And if you don't see the options for NAT network, then simply go to files, click on tools, then click on network manager, then click on NAT networks, and if you don't see any, then click on create. Now go back to virtual machine we created and click on start. Now select graphical install with your arrow keys and press enter. Now select this language, I'll go with English. Use enter to hit continue. Select your location, I'll use American English as my keyboard. Let it configure things. Let the host name be Kali, no need for domain name. Now write your full name. Choose a username. Remember, we are going to use the username to log in, so remember the username. Put a password. Of course, you have to put a password, unlike Windows. Now select the time zone. In the partition disk, we will use guided and use the entire disk. Click continue. Now click on finish partitioning and write changes to the disk. Select yes, write the changes to disk. Now when you see software selection, we don't need to change anything here. Let it be default and click on continue. Now this is gonna take some time, so let it install. Now here is the important part. When it asks you to install the grub bootloader, you have to select install the grub booter to your primary drive, and then again you have to select the device for bootloader installation, and for that you have to select -dev -sda. This is important. If you mess up here, then you won't be able to boot into your Kali, so select carefully. And the installation is complete. Now click on continue and your virtual machine will restart. As you can see, we have successfully installed Kali Linux on our Windows operating system using a software called VirtualBox. Now before we conclude this episode, let's talk about some homework. Your homework for this episode is to complete the Google IT support course. It's completely free and it will give you the basic and the fundamentals you need for IT and networking. So in order to have a better understanding of what we are doing, you have to have some theoretical knowledge, and that course will provide you all the theoretical knowledge you need. Like, it will introduce you to networking, protocols, ports, subnetting and similar concepts. So please complete the course before the next episode is out. Now if you have any questions, then please comment it down, and have any constructive criticism, then let me know. I'm always looking to improve. If you want community support and direct help from me, then join the Telegram group linked below. If you enjoyed this video and want to continue this course, then subscribe to this channel and also click on the bell icon so you get notified when my next episode drops. See you in the next episode.